Hello, everybody, and we are back with episode 10 of the Between Elysium Let's Play series. Last episode, we left off, and I was getting together an automated milk thing so we can generate Sano Essence. We ran out of time, and I said we'd pick it up this episode, which is exactly what we were going to do. So I just wanted to show you all what I wound up doing, and if you hadn't noticed, I liked compact setups. So I like small, neat, compact setups. So here's what we did. First things first, when we left off, we had the two items placed, the two autonomous activators, and it was just a matter of getting the bucket to activate to milk the cow and then into the other activator to fill up the tank. So it's not a very hard setup. So here's what we did. We went into our power plant area and we set up a tesseract. Okay, the tesseract is pulling energy from the resident energy cell, and we're going to be transporting that power into our thaumaturgy lab, the thaumatorium. I like that, thaumatorium. This is now known as the thaumatorium. So the energy is being transferred to our thaumatorium, and it's being transferred right there. So behind this is a bunch of, well, not a bunch of, a line of resonant energy, ducts, which, there you go, you can see right there, resonant energy ducts, and flux ducts. And what is going on is actually very relatively simple. So what we have here is a very simple setup. Power is going to the two autonomous activators. Okay, they're getting power from the sides over here. Our cow is in here, and the bucket is in here. So, now what are these two things? Well, these two things are actually from Automagy, and what they are, this is a tally box, and this is a remote comparator. What the tally box does is it reads the contents of an inventory. So right now, the tally box is reading the contents of the autonomous activator, and it sees that there's a milk bucket in there. The autonomous activator is set to operate only under a high redstone signal. So right now, because there is a whitelist in here for a milk bucket, you may say, well, there is a milk bucket in there, so why is it not emitting a redstone signal? Because I have the comparator up top, which you can kind of think of it as it's monitoring it changes the functionality. You know what, I'll just read it, actually. This way I don't mix it up. So what's going to happen with the tally box is you could place a remote comparator above the box and then attune a crystallian eye to the inventory you want to examine. Then place that eye into the comparator. The comparator will cease its normal function and instead will relay item information for the tally box to act upon. So, what we have here is a tuned crystallian eye, which is watching this inventory. Now watch, once we put it into the remote comparator, I'm gonna actually lower the music a little bit. There we go. I don't know if it's too loud, it's very hard to judge. It's very difficult to judge with headphones. So I lowered the music a little bit, hopefully that's helpful. Anyway, what the crystallian eye is going to do, once I place it into the comparator, ta-da! Now, what is it doing? It detects, oh, okay, we're looking to see if there's an inventory in here. Right now, there's not, so we're not doing anything. So now, what's going to happen is there's a pipe under there that pulls out the milk bucket. It goes in there, milks the cow, gets inserted, and boom, 1,000. And then the comparator stops activating because it detected that there was an empty bucket, so the redstone signal stops running, the autonomous activator stops doing its thing, and therefore, the cycle just repeats. Milk bucket in there, redstone signal, fill bucket, bucket empty, pull out empty bucket, close redstone signal, rinse and repeat. And it's just going to keep doing this. Eventually, what's going to happen is this milk bucket is, this tank is going to get full, and then we just shut this down, which I'll probably automate in the future, but that's not going to happen for a little while. And there you go. And it just keeps going. and then it's gonna cycle. There's the bucket, milk, pump, in, poop, fill up, pull out, repeat. And there you go, you have automated milk. So, now I said we were gonna get into the second part of this, which is once we have the milk automatically generating, we wanna break this down into Sano, because Sano is a pain to get. So here's how the Sano's gonna, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take, you put this stuff away. We don't need this. We might need this because we need some food. All right, and we don't need this. We'll keep that though. All right, so what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna get an alchemical boiler. So that's under here. So we need a crucible and a furnace and some iron. So let's get a crucible, furnace, and iron. Let's do it. All right. Okay. We need a crucible. We're going to need a furnace. And we're going to need more iron. I'm actually, you know what I think I'm going to do? Maybe not on camera. I think I'm going to expand this. I'm going to run my draw controller up here. Or I'm going to create a chest up here that pumps into the draw controller. I think that's a good idea. I'm not going to do that now, but that's just something I'm going to plan for in the future. Okay, so we need to make a crucible. So let's get our cauldron and crucible. Okay. We have our furnace, and we're going to need iron, I said, right? Yes. And I just put the iron away because I'm moving too quick. There we go. Let's go back to our thaumatorium. And we're going to make ourselves a chemical boiler. Okay, perfect. And now you might be saying, what does the chemical boiler do, Hailstorm? Well, my dearest viewer, the alchemical boiler does the following. It takes exactly what you would think. The same way a furnace works. Furnace burns down physical items into essentia. The boiler takes liquids using buckets or through automation, such as certain golems, to distill down essentia. And that's it. So we have a boiler. We're going to put our boiler in this room. Now, mind you, I've never used the alchemical boiler before. Wow, this is actually filling up a lot faster than I thought. Okay. Hey, all right. I've never actually used the boiler before, so this is actually going to be a first for me. We're going to stick it, I think, in the corner right here, because why not? Let's see. If I run the thing there... Alright, so the loop goes under here. The boiler pipe can go from here, turn here. Alright, so let's put the boiler in the corner. That's it? That's what the boiler is? I thought it was like bigger than that. Huh. Okay. Well, I'm not complaining. We're gonna probably want to put some Alemnix on it though. Yeah, probably going to want to put some Alemnix on it. So let's go make some Alemnix. Like I said, I've never used the boiler before. So you might be sitting there in YouTube land watching me right now and saying, Oh, Hailstorm, you're so silly. You're supposed to use the boiler like this. And I'm saying, well, yeah. Okay, I don't exactly know how to use it, and I'm going to probably make a fool of myself while you're sitting there knowing how to use it. And so let's see. We're going to make some alembics. Alembic, alembic, alembic. Where are you? Alembic. We need some of these filters, which are cool. We need these filters. We need some silver planks and some gold, which we got. So yeah, what I was saying was, I hope I'm using the boiler right. But hey, we'll figure it out. I'll figure it out. But for now, just do what we do. Let's make some two piece filters. We'll make four. Why not? I'm sure we'll use them later on. And we're gonna take the iron and some buckets. Yeah, I should just carry a stack of iron on me. Iron. We are gonna need some more gold. And we're gonna need some buckets. Buckets, buckets, buckets. Here we go. Oh, I actually had a bucket in my inventory. I don't really need you anymore, so you can go there. So that is that the alembic recipe? I already forgot. Alembic. It's actually like this. And two. Alright. So hopefully. Did I not? I did make a second. Okay. Hopefully the boiler works the way I think it does. And hopefully I'm able to just place these two alembics on top of it like I could a regular furnace. But if not, no, it looks like you can. Looks like it's connecting. Yeah, it looks like you can do it this way. I don't know if it requires anything else. You know what we can actually do? Let's just test it. Let's grab a bucket and just test it. That's not a bad idea, right? I mean, gotta do what we gotta do. So let's take our bucket and let's get some milk. We could actually just take it right from here. Why not? There we go. And just that? No? Oh, we do need some coal. I do need that. Do I have actually any chaos coal left over? I think I do. I do. Chaos coal. We're just going to take a little bit. There we go. And the liquid cannot be broken down into a sensor. Really? Why can milk not be broken down into a sensor? Are you telling me that I've taken this entire time and I am not able to break milk down into Essentia? Seriously? Why not? Why can't I do this? Okay. I don't know why milk can't be broken down into Essentia. That doesn't make any sense. Milk. Automagy. This makes no sense to me. I don't know why this is happening. at all. Well, that really sucks, actually. I mean, here it is. Milk. So, like, what can be broken down? I don't get it at all. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to pause here and look into this, because I'm fairly certain you should be able to break milk down into Sano. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take a quick break slash pause and look into this and figure out what's going on. So I'll be back in a few. Well, we are back, and wow. So what seemed like about 5 seconds for you all in YouTube land, if you actually look at the clock in the bottom right corner of my screen, can see it was quite a bit longer for me in recording land. Yeah, there were some major issues that happened to really suck. Turns out that the reason why the milk was not essentially breaking down was because vanilla milk, for whatever reason, is not registered correctly to provide the essentia needed for the alchemical boiler. Now, normally that'd be all right, because the mod Automagy itself provides, and if you look, it provides its own milk. So one would think that by milking the cow and placing it in a tank, that you would be pulling Automagy milk, in which case you can boil that down, get your essentia, what have you. No, that was not the case. Because despite all my testing, despite everything I tried to do, even forcing Automagy milk into this tank, it would always pump out as regular milk, which had no essentia, which couldn't be broken down. So, what did I have to do? After researching and trying to mess with Mindtweaker and ModTweaker, unfortunately, Automagy support is not in Mindtweaker or ModTweaker, so it didn't help. There was no way for me to add aspects into vanilla milk, so that didn't work. Nothing worked. So what did I have to do? Well, I had to install a new mod. And the new mod that got installed into the pack and updated with the pack was Mine Factory Reloaded. Yeah. Of all the mods that I did not want to add, that would be number one on the list. Not because I don't enjoy Mine Factory Reloaded, not at all, but because Mine Factory Reloaded has so many potential game-breaking things in it, at least for this pack specifically, that I specifically avoided putting it in this pack. Unfortunately, though, Mine Factory Reloaded adds its own milk. And its milk overrides the vanilla Minecraft milk, as well as configurations in Automagy allow Automagy to use the Mine Factory Reloaded milk. However, it overrides the Mine Factory Reloaded milk's aspects. Yeah. So, Mine Factory Reloaded had to get added into the pack, specifically for the reason of having milk that the alchemical boiler can process. Now, a significant amount of recipes then had to be disabled by me in Mine Factory Reloaded. And then I had to up the power cost of a huge amount of machines in Mine Factory Reloaded to try and restore the massive amount of balance that was broken in the pack. And it's still not done yet. It's going to be undergoing a lot of tweaks. Then recipes are going to change. As I've been speaking in all previous episodes, I specifically modified recipes and gated certain mods behind other mods so that you would have to get into Advent of Ascension in order to progress through another mod, or you'd have to get into Big Reactors or Garden Core, etc., etc., to use and continue other mods, because I like cross mod play. What does that mean? That means that Mind Factory Reloaded recipes are also going to be undergoing the same treatment in time. So there'll be frequent updates. Even if they're small ones, just changing scripts, it's going to happen. All right. All of that said, so Mind Factory Reloaded gets installed. And as you can see, my milk system is still working. The bucket should be coming out anytime soon. Where are you, bucket? Bucket, where are you? It's around here somewhere. There it is. Bucket. And in you go, and then into the tank. There you go. So with that said, great. Awesome job, Hale. You know, you added in Mind Factory Reloaded, you tweaked the recipes. What else took so long? Well, my friends, I corrupted this world. Three times over. Yep. Now, this is not my first rodeo, so I managed to, as you can see, recover the world exactly as it was. But I corrupted the world three times. Because this is not... This mod pack isn't a large mod pack in a sense where there's just so much content. There is so much content. But the mod pack is large in a sense that a very large chunk of item IDs are being used up. And unfortunately, you know, there is a hard code limit to how many item IDs, block IDs, entity IDs, data watcher IDs, you name it, there is almost always a hard code limit. And by adding Mind Factory Reloaded, the single player version works fine, because when you create a new world, you know, all the IDs are created and assigned right then and there, and Minecraft does what it needs to assign and make sure that the IDs are going where they're supposed to. And if they don't, you'll crash. That's not the same on a server, as you may guess, because on a server, the data files are saved. They're in the, you know, they're saved, level data is saved. So IDs, even though they may be abandoned IDs, are still already assigned. So by installing Mind Factory Reloaded, single player works fine, but while trying to install it onto this server, Minecraft did what it had to do and tried to reassign IDs that were not in use but to the Mind Factory Reloaded machines, and well, guess what? ran over the limit and corrupted the world, and everything I tried to do, removing mods, adding mods, changing IDs, doing what I can, didn't matter. The world kept getting corrupted. And I had to revert the world to fix the corruption. Back and forth, back and forth. Finally, I went past the Minecraft hard code limit and implemented a mod that bypasses, or rather not bypasses, increases the hard code limit of blocks that are allowed, as well as entities, data watchers, and all of that. Quite honestly, I don't plan to use it too much, but I had to use it in order to get the world to where it was and to get MFR playable and not world corrupting. And with all of that said, we're back with our milk tank, automated, filling, tally box, remote comparator, Crystallian Eye, operating swimmingly. And finally, I had a stone golem laying around and created a animation core for decanting. I had it in a chest and I forgot about it, to be honest. And here we go. We have our little boiler right here. And we have our almanac, alembic, right there. And what we're going to do is we're going to have our golem assigned to the alchemical boiler. And we're going to put an animation core on him. And he's going to grab a bucket like a good little golem. And then we're going to take our golem mancer's bell, and we're going to take him, and we're going to say, dude, you go from there, and you go collect your milk. I don't know if that's enough range. Is that enough range for you? It is good. And you're going to take that milk, and you're going to bring it to the alchemical boiler. And the alchemical boiler is going to fill up and not have the X up here. And the alchemical boiler is going to fill up, and it's going to say it's 2 aqua, 2 famous, and 2 sano. And we're going to get some coal. You know what? We're going to go crazy. We're going to get some chaos coal, because I'm feeling adventurous. So we're going to get some chaos coal. And what is chaos coal? I think it's this. Chaos coal. Chaos coal. Oh, it's coal around this. It's okay. We're going to get some chaos coal. And we're going to take that chaos coal, and we're going to put it in that boiler. And watch we crash or something like that with my luck. We're going to put it in that boiler. And we're going to cook up the Essentia. That's right. And the Sano's going to go in there. And the Famas is going to go in there. And the Aqua's going to stay in here. And we're going to have a golem. And we're going to automate the Sano Famas production. And guess what we're going to do after that? We're going to take the vat from Thomic Horizons, I think. And we're going to probably be able to supply that vat with unlimited Famas and Sano because we have a milk farm going. And that, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube, is how I freaking finally automated a Sano Famas Essentia boiler and making it via milk. That's right. I did it. And this is a creepy cave. I love my sound overhaul. Everything you hear in the background, all the new sounds and stuff like that, that's part of a sound overhaul. And it is awesome. Like, this music playing in the background is actually Minecraft music. And that clicking you hear, like footprints, that's coming from in there because it's overhauling dungeon music. So cool. But with that and that extremely long explanation, we're actually out of time for this video. But, you know, I'm very happy. I'm very happy that it finally got to work. You know, it sucks that I had to go through all of that. And, you know, somebody who is not experienced would have probably, I don't know what they would have done. But I am thankful for having the background savvy of creating mod packs, creating mods, and running servers, and knowing what I'm doing, to be able to have resolved the issue and got it functioning the way I wanted it to. So, yeah. It's great. What I was going to do the rest of this episode, but we're not going to have time, is I was going to take everything that this is pumping out and have it pumped out into here. Like I said in the prior episode, I was going to take it pumped out, crystallize any excess and stuff like that. I think I'm going to reevaluate that, and I might do it something else. I might make it, I don't know yet. I'm going to think about it. This has actually taken a lot out of me. Not, you know, not tiring-wise, more like I'm flustered. And in being flustered, I kind of lost focus on everything that I had planned for the next couple episodes relating to Thomcraft specifically. So I'm still going to upload episodes much more frequently now, and I'm still going to, you know, continue this, but I'm going to probably rethink the way I was originally going to do it. Or I might just do it the same way. Really, all I was going to do was take a pipe, essentially a pipe, pump it out from the Albanac into some storage room, have the V crystallize with the Essentia crystallization, and then store the Essentia crystals. That's really all I was going to do. But that's kind of boring, is really what I'm saying. So I want to kind of make it more, like, fun. Maybe I'll use golems or something like that. I don't know. But either way, I'm glad that this all worked out. I hope you enjoyed this video. You know, I don't see many videos that combine these types of mods together and, you know, you use things in this way. So I hope it provides entertainment value for all of you. And if you do like the video, please do subscribe. It does help me out. Do leave a like. And if you don't like the video, then leave a dislike. That's fine, you know. I would like it if you do dislike the video. Explain why. What can I do that changes it? What can I do to make things different that will, you know, make you enjoy the video? Do I talk too much? Am I annoying? I don't know. You tell me. That's the beauty of the internet. Are you gonna, you know, you probably could even, you could troll me. I've been trolled numerous times. You know, there's gonna be trolls out there. That's fine. You know, I don't feed trolls. It's okay. But yeah, with that, we're gonna close this episode off. We have an automated Sano production. We have an automated milk farm, and we've combined atomology, thermal expansion, thermal dynamics, and bombcraft. And I love cross mod play. So I hope you all enjoyed this episode. Take care, and we'll see you next time.